Hello everyone and welcome to our Daily Manna. Kindly open our Bibles together in the Gospel of Luke chapter 7 verses 36 to 40. The word of the Lord says, "One day one of the Pharisees invited Jesus to his house. So Jesus went to his house and sat down to eat. In that city there was a sinful woman. When she learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house, she went there and brought expensive nard perfume in an alabaster jar. When she arrived at the house, she knelt near Jesus' feet and started crying, her tears wetting Jesus' feet. Then she wiped his feet with her hair, kissed them, and poured the perfume on his feet. When the Pharisee saw what the woman did, he thought to himself, 'If this man were a prophet, he would know what kind of woman is touching him. She is a sinner.' But Jesus knew what he was thinking. So he spoke to the Pharisee, 'Simon, I have something to say to you.' Simon replied, 'Teacher, what is it?'" May God bless us from the reading of his word. There are two important characters in this story. One is Simon, a well-known religious leader, a Pharisee. The other is a woman, known in the place as a sinner. Through this story, we can see that Jesus knew both of them and their lives. He knows each one of us and what is happening in our lives. This event happened in front of Simon's guest, the Pharisee. To Simon, it was inappropriate for a sinful woman to touch a teacher or a prophet. That's why he thought, "Is this man really a prophet? If he were, he would know that the woman touching his feet is a sinner." But Jesus did not rebuke the woman. She approached him humbly, crying, deeply ashamed of her sinful life. Her tears fell on Jesus' feet. Jesus knew what was happening in the woman's life. Observing her tears, he saw her insincerity and repentance. That's why Jesus accepted the woman's offering. He knew what kind of woman was washing his feet with her tears, but she showed her faith and honor to Jesus. Between the two, Simon showed no desire to honor Jesus, while the sinful woman showed her faith and honor to Jesus through her actions. That's why Jesus forgave her sins. Jesus knew about the woman's life and also about Simon's thoughts, the Pharisee who was observing. So Jesus said in verse 40, "I have something to say to you, Simon." Simon replied, "Teacher, speak." Jesus responded to Simon's thoughts with a story in the Gospel of Luke chapter 7 verses 41 to 49. It says, "A man lent money to two people. One owed him 500 pesos, the other 50 pesos. Neither of them could pay, so he forgave both. Now, who will love him more?" Simon replied, "The one who had the bigger debt forgiven." Jesus said, "You have judged correctly." Then Jesus turned to the woman and said to Simon, "Do you see this woman? I came into your house and you did not give me water to wash the dust of my feet, but she wet my feet with her tears and wiped them with her hair. You did not greet me with a kiss, but she has not stopped kissing my feet. You did not anoint my head with oil, but she has poured perfume on my feet. Therefore, I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, as her great love has shown, but whoever has been forgiven, little loves little." Simon, a Pharisee, had strict moral laws to ensure a clean life. He was puzzled by why Jesus accepted the sinful woman touching his feet. Why didn't Jesus rebuke her? According to the law of Moses in Leviticus, anything or anyone touched by a defiled person becomes defiled. Due to his moral laws, Simon concluded that Jesus could not be a prophet or the Messiah. If Jesus were truly from God, he would know what kind of woman was touching him or would not allow it. How can a holy person be with a sinner? In the Pharisee's mind, there were only two possibilities. Either Jesus did not know the woman's background, or he did not know but did not care. Either way, the Pharisee thought Jesus was not a prophet, and certainly not the Messiah. Even though Simon was very religious, He did not think about the character of God he claimed to love. God loves and forgives. Simon needed to realize that what he thought was wrong and did not reflect the character of God. In Numbers chapter 14, verse 18, we read that God is slow to anger and abounding in love. He forgives all kinds of sins and rebellion. Jesus accepted the woman who repented, showing her repentance. Jesus demonstrated God's love for those who repent of their sins. In Mark chapter 2, verse 17, Jesus said, "I have come to call not the righteous, but sinners." The woman needed forgiveness and a completely new life. She needed forgiveness of her sins for her sins, and her journey with Jesus brought her to the only one who could help her. Jesus came to the world for the salvation of all people through him. Simon needed to understand this, and Jesus was willing to speak with him. Let's pray. O Lord Jesus Christ, as what you have said in John chapter 14, verse 6, that you are the way, the life, and the truth, no one comes to the Father except through me. That's why, Lord, we need to dedicate and commit our lives fully to you, because everything here in this world is temporary. You have prepared a place for us in heaven where there is no more pain, no more death, no more sorrow, or even suffering. While we are here in this world, let us not forget that you are the owner of our lives, and every day counts before you. Lord Jesus, help us understand that our life here in this world is precious in God's sight. Thank you, Lord, for your sacrifice to save us from eternal condemnation and death, giving us eternal life in a place where there will be no more sorrow or crying, because you have made everything new. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for being our Savior and King in our lives. Amen and amen. In Romans chapter 10, verse 13 says, "Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved." Simon did not know about Jesus because he had not spoken with him. Similarly, many of our acquaintances, friends, and even relatives do not know about Jesus and remain without hope until they learn that Jesus is willing to forgive everyone. Call upon the name of Jesus. Shalom and good day, everyone.